We are going to discuss something unique this time. The topic is the logo, scientific logo and the arrows. Okay, so before I go forward, I'm going to check whether I'm live already and am I, it's like, you know, the voice is there or not. So let me check on the Facebook. Okay. Yeah, I'm live already there. And yeah, great. So great. Awesome. That's nice. The sound is also there. So let's start with this. You know, first of all, let me make you aware about what is scientific logo. So what happens? You know, whenever your mind is already on this earth from plenty of years. Okay. It was there before you. It will be there after you. When I say after you, it's like, you know, you always got birth, rebirth again and again. So now, because of the years of programming, your mind is now being programmed by these symbols. So what is the symbol? What is the symbol? Symbol is like the language of subconscious mind. So let's assume this is the circle and this is the square. So it's like if you see any diagram, any drawing on this kind of drawing is there. Okay, I'm going to draw. See, my drawing is very great, so you will enjoy the way I'm drawing right now. So if I draw this kind of one diagram, and if I draw another kind of diagram, okay. So if I ask you, which is male and which is female, what will you say? So we will say that this is a male and this is a female. So without you being aware about the forms, how did you decide it? Okay, this is male, this is female. It's because male have straighter bodies and females have curvier bodies. So subconsciously we understand the importance of symbols. You know, subconsciously we know what red color is, what is the advantage of red color, what is what is the meaning of red color, what is the meaning of orange color. So subconsciously, whether you know or whether you don't know, consciously, subconsciously your mind is already aware. Because you got the birth in terms of different animals, different species. So this mind of yours has got the information of all the things already. So now your mind always try to communicate, because your mind will never understand your verbal language. It will always understand your symbolic language, subconscious language. So because the signature is again a symbol, and because the logo is again a symbol, they both are going to communicate a lot with your subconscious mind. So all the points of subconscious mind is related. It's related to the symbolic thing. So now when we talk about logos, when we talk about symbols, what are we talking about? We are talking about that how these formations basically interact with you, how this formation is basically going to influence you. So before going, see, today's topic is arrow in the logo. Arrows in the logo. In the logo. This is the topic. Okay. So arrows in the logo is the topic. Now, while discussing this, when discussing arrows in the logo, let's understand what is the meaning of arrow. Okay, so before that, let's understand what is the meaning of circle. So the dot means a thought. So the perfect definition of dot in the geometry is like the dot never has length, width, or breadth. So it has, technically it has no existence. So when you don't have any kind of manifestation, it's a dot. If you are, it's like a thought. Until and unless you take action on thought, it's very difficult for you to manifest the thing. So the dot is a thought. And when this dot has an expression of the desire, the expression of doing something, so that becomes its radius. And when that expression manifests, this becomes a life. So the circle is the life. Circle is the life. Circle is you. Circle is the pure subconscious mind. And, you know, circle, that is why the earth is circular in nature. It's a sphere. A two-dimensional thing of the sphere will be a circle. So always a circle will give the life to something. That is why these planets and everything is circular in nature. You know, what happens, you know, when you might be aware about this story where there was a beam of light. When Vishnu and the Brahma were fighting for superiority, Brahma said that I am the greatest because I create things. Vishnu said, I am the greatest because I take care of things. And both were fighting, and suddenly one light emerged. And that light had no end. That beam of light has had no end and no beginning. So what they both decided, let's go and search what is there, you know. And the person who is going to find the end of this thing, that person will be declared as the champion, and that person will be the greatest among the two. So Brahma flew on the swan. Okay, he started floating, you know, he went up. Years passed by, months passed by, and still it was difficult for him to get the end. And Vishnu took the form of bow and it started digging the ground, and it went deep inside the ground. And months passed by, years passed by, and it was difficult for him to find the end. So Vishnu accepted his defeat. He came back and he saw Brahma as well over there. And before even Brahma could say something, the Vishnu said, I accept my defeat. I was not able to find the end to it. And Brahma said, yeah, I was able to find the end to it. And that is the time when that light had this bang and Shiva emerged out of it. And he said, you are a liar, to Brahma. And because of that, it's like Brahma has never been praised or worshipped anywhere else in the country, because this was a punishment, or this was a curse given to him by the Lord Shiva. So now Shiva, Brahma is a creator, so he is into forms, all the forms. So he's creating from geometrical forms all the time, whereas Vishnu knows his limitations. Vishnu knows his limitations, so he takes the form again and again, but a limited number of forms, 9 avatars, or he will always take a form. Brahma is creating forms, trying to create a perfect form. And Vishnu knows his limitation. That's why he is into getting into some kind of form. So he is akar hai, wo akar hai. So both people are doing that. Now, when we talk about Vishnu, when you talk about Shiva, Shiva has no form. So Shiva is above all the forms. So when there is nothing, there is a Shiva. Then there is everything, there is Shiva. So it's like Shiva talks about nirakar, you know, there is no akar. That's why the black, the entire black color is called as the color of Shiva, because it is everywhere and it has no shape, no size, nothing. No? So it's like that. So when we talk about this akar, nirakar, the akar means the manifestation. So what happened? That light was there. That light was like this. It has no end, no beginning, nothing was there. It was like that. And this beam of light wanted to experience this energy. This energy wanted to experience the life. This Shakti was, you know, interested in knowing what is there. So these things took a bend. And then it realized something, that it tested the light. Now this light wants to go back to the origin. But you know what? When this light took the curve, what happened? Some karma happened, some action happened. And now without clearing those karmas, without clearing those issues, without clearing their karma, it cannot go back to the origin. Now, for this light to go back to the origin, it needs to get freedom from the karma. It needs to get the freedom from Mona. When this cycle will break, then only this light can go back to the ultimate light, ultimate power, the purity, or nirakar, or the ultimate reality. Now it is stuck in this maya. This is called as maya. This maya, everything is a manifestation of maya, because that maya wanted to experience. Okay, you will find this kind of talk in Christianity as well. You will find this kind of talk everywhere, because now when you talk about this curve is nothing but what? This curve is nothing but feminine thought. This is the emotions. When I talk about emotions, if you go and look into the Christianity, you find a similar kind of thing in Christianity as well, where a lady is trying to influence male to do something, to realize or to manifest or to, you know, experience something. So Adam and Eve ask Adam to taste something, you know, that is, the taste means what? Taste means experience. So this bend in the light is this talks about the experience. Okay, so now this we establish as a fact that curve and the bend are nothing but a life consciousness. This straight line will have no consciousness. Straight line will always be no consciousness. But the moment this straight line we have bend, this bend will be life. So the circle is life. Circle is life. So this is a pure subconscious mind. This thing is pure subconscious mind. So this is the ultimate reality. This is like sky, akashta. Sky. Now what? Now comes the element of Prithvi, the earth. Now this is the earth element. This element is earth element. Now, when we talk about earth element, you see it's stable. No? The square is stable. It's difficult for you to tip it off. You know, if you apply force from here, it will be difficult for you to make it fall. So earth element gives you a lot of stability. Earth element means you stable. In terms of logos also, if you have the logos in this kind of form, it will make you very slow. It will make you very sluggish. And it will also add a lot of stability to your life. This is earth element. And now, if you talk about, let's assume you talk about fire. Now, what is fire? Whenever you see fire burning up, you will see this kind of formations. So the fire will always be going in this kind of formation. This is fire. So fire always travels upward. So this is nothing but the fire. So upward triangle shows the fire. So this is now upward triangle showing the fire. Okay, so this is now is a fire. Now when you talk about water, how water flows, water will always flow in this direction. Water will always be flowing in this direction. It will find the ways in this direction. Whenever you throw water, it will go in this direction. So always water will always want to have the point towards downward. So this is what this symbol of water. So this is water, this is fire, and then comes the symbol of air. Now air flows in which direction? Air flows in this direction, air flows in this direction. So air is circulating all the time, to and fro. So these two triangles will show the formation of air. So this was the sky, earth, then fire, water, and you have the air. So these are the basic element with which you form a logo. These are the basic element with which you form a logo. Now, when you talk about the arrows, now this is the arrow. This is arrow. So you will find this kind of formation in plenty of logos. We are going to discuss all those logos today. So when you talk about this arrow, what is happening in this arrow? That you find that arrow is nothing but the AI element. Oh, oops, wrong spelling. So I'm from Marathi medium, so I might have a lot of spelling mistakes and a lot of things. And you guys are very courteous that you always pinpoint out, and you ask on my private chat that, okay, these things are wrong, but it's okay. I don't mind, you know. Anyway, my base is not the English base. So I'm speaking, I'm having this book on logos as well. The name of the book is Million Dollar Logo. So it's like, I have done enough to prove that I know a bit of English, but more than English, I know my subject. That is what matters to me. So when I talk about the arrow, this element is air element. So what will happen to the companies which has the arrow as their logo? So now let's go and check which all companies has this kind of logo. So I'm going to make you aware about, let's see, I'm going to make you aware about the logos which has the arrows. So logos which has arrows. Do you know any company which has arrow in their logo? Okay, so the first company which comes to everybody's mind, which has this particular element, you know, the element of arrow, according to me, is HSBC. I have worked with the HSBC as well in the past. Yeah. So like if you observe this FedEx logo, what do you see? Okay, I will share the screen again for all of you. So if you observe this FedEx logo, what is happening? It also has the arrow element into it, but this arrow element is not visible. So you see this arrow element is there in this logo as well. Here they have used the arrow element. Then you have the arrow element in the logo of Arrow Shirts logo. So if you observe the Arrow Shirts logo, here also you see that it has the arrow at the base. So I don't know much about the arrow, but people who have worked with the arrow might be able to tell you something regarding their execution. Now we also divide the logos in multiple parts. You know, there are fine elements. It's like if you know a bit of graphology, you will understand there are upper zone, middle zone, lower zones, then past, present, future. You know, there are multiple ways in which we need to break it down and understand. So here, if you see, the logo of arrow has a base to it. Now this is the base. Now when we talk about the base, it's like I don't know much about the arrow right now in terms of shirts, but this company will be very good in terms of forming a base. These people will be very, very fast in terms of forming a base. So then we have a logo of Accenture. So if you see Accenture logo, they have added arrow at the top of the T. You see? So it's like they want to uplift the, this T is basically for self-esteem. So they want to uplift the image of company. So that is what they have, you know, this arrow is coming at the top of the T. Then you have the company name is Amazon. Now Amazon, surprisingly, you, I will, I'm going to show you two logos, you know, Amazon company logo. So see, now there are two logos. Now when you observe Amazon, what is the logo? You know, now this is the logo where this is the logo of Amazon.com, which is used in the US. And whereas this logo is the logo of Amazon.in, which has been used in the India. You see, there is a difference in the way the curve has been formed. Here, this line curve is different. And here, the curve is different. And believe me, guys, when I discussed this particular case with one of my students who has worked with the Amazon.com as well as Amazon.in, and when we discussed and when I told my analysis to him, he said, exactly, this is what happens in the Amazon. So this arrows has a significant meaning, you know. Then which else company is there, you know, this for them? Let's search. There are plenty of companies who have used the arrow element as their logo. Okay, arrow in the logo of company. So, okay, I don't know many companies over here, famous company, arrows in the famous company logo. Let's search. So FedEx is there. Okay, then I don't know which other company has used other than Amazon, FedEx. If you know any, can you comment? You know, I saw a lot of people, a lot of you are watching. If you know any logo in particular which has used the arrows as a symbol to their organization, we will be able to discuss those. Okay, so there is one company which has been not understood by you people. That is company Shell. I was just Shell company logo. So when you observe Shell company, what happens with the Shell company? Just observe it, you know, what is happening with the Shell? It's like, now Shell company also has the arrows, you know. See, when we discuss about the basic arrow shape, this which we discuss is this. So this is this formation of red arrows are there in Shell company as well. Now these arrows are elongated, no doubt, but these are, this is again the air element. So this again has a lot of significance. No? So there are multiple logos, plenty of logos which are going to use the arrow element without they being aware about it, that it is an arrow. And depending upon the organization, these arrows are going to help at times, and these arrows are going to sabotage the movement of the company at times. So when these arrows, I know, see, left arrow is there, right arrow is there, but at times left arrow is also good, at times right arrow is good. It totally depends on the way you guys are going to perform the work. For example, if you observe this Shell logo, what is happening in Shell logo? It's like there are movement in the downside. If you observe this particular logo, what is happening? This Shell company's logo arrow are in the downside towards the earth. So it's like they will find all the possible resources to get the oil. So the places which you have not imagined, the places where you feel like there would be no oil, the Shell company went and found oil over there. So that is the mindset of this organization. When you have arrows, so much of arrows, you know, and see the level at which that arrow has gone down. So that much of efforts they are going to get to reach to the source. So if you know a bit of about Shell company has been able to get and extract oil from unimaginable places. So that is what this arrow means, you know. So similarly, there will be multiple companies, and the way the arrow is, it is going to define the way they are going to work. So if I have any, if you have any questions regarding this particular arrow topic, if you want to know something unique, you can ask me the questions. If you have question, I will answer those. Or else, I have given a lot of information today regarding how logo works, how element works, how arrow works. And this knowledge is not available on Google. This knowledge is not available in any other book. And this is my own R&D. I have done a lot of research. I have given a lot of results to a lot of organizations already. And with those results, with that experience, I'm teaching, I'm speaking. And when you talk about ancient symbols, you know, a few days back, I was talking about Om, Swastik, then Shri Yantra. So all these logos, all these symbols, when you use as a logo, if you talk about Yantra, what is Yantra basically, you know, all those Shri Yantra and all. So these Yantras have been, you know, created, or, you know, there is a particular word which people use, which I don't remember right now, but when they were created, they were consecrated, you know, consecrated in the sense there is a vidhi, there is a procedure with which there are rituals. If you perform in a particular way, if you utter those mantras, these things will form, and these things are going to give a lot of energy to you, no doubt about it. So what happens in case of, these, symbols which are there in the books, which are there in the scriptures mentioned already, because a lot of people have thought positive about the symbol, a lot of people have given their intention to that symbol. It's now, it's like now, this particular symbol will have that energy for eternity. The way Swastik is, the way Shri Yantra is, the way Om is. So the moment you have the Om symbol, it's like that symbol is a symbol of universal energy. So that particular symbol is going to influence you with that kind of energy all the time, because that symbol has been consecrated by that process, and that symbol has been given the power in that particular way. But now, when we talk about this symbol using as a logo, so when you use these symbols as a logo, what happens is, because of the positivity given to that symbol from so many generations, that symbol is going to bring some kind of positivity to you all the time. But there is a but, whatever physical interpretation, whatever geometrical interpretation you can have out of those symbols, those things are going to manifest in your life as well. So positivity will also be there, and at the same time, some negativity will also add into your life because of the wrong formation of this symbol. Because its physical formation will be different. So cosmic formation is going to help you, but a physical formation is going to trouble you. It's like you will have a lot of good opportunities in your life, but those opportunities will not manifest in your life in that way. So this is about the symbols which are already there, proven, existential, and the symbol which have big name in the market. So that was regarding the symbol of old things. Now, when I talk about the symbols, like for example, now yantras. So technically, yantras are never a two-dimensional thing. Yantras will always be either three-dimensional or a multi-dimensional. So it's like if you have a pyramid. So whenever a pyramid gets energized, so pyramid, this is, let me show you on my, I will share the screen and I will show you what I'm trying to say. So it's like, okay. So I'm going to share the screen. Okay, this is the screen. Now this is the pyramid. So what happens with this pyramid is when energy falls on this. Okay. So you see, this has been explained to me by one of my friend, a student, whose name is Ravindra Rao. So he's an expert in yantras, and we were having discussion regarding this, and what he told me, I have understood. I'm just trying to explain it. There's a chance that I might make mistakes, but you try to understand this concept. Now you know about the Shiva having the Ganga in his jata. So what is the reason? You know, it's like when Bhagirath called for a Ganga, Ganga came to the earth. But now, what will happen is like, one second, let me also. It's like, now what will happen that Ganga was traveling with such a force, such a large force, that if Shankar wouldn't have wrapped her in her in his jata, it's like she would have fallen to the earth and directly went could have went into the Patal Lok. You know, so because whenever the energy is going to come, it's going to come in large force. Energy is going to come in a large force. So that energy has to be broken down. So whenever the energy will fall into this, it will break out, you know, and only the pure form, the purest form of energy, which is helpful, which is, it's like purest form of the energy, which is helpful and will go over here, and rest all unwanted energy will get scattered along the way. So this is how the Shriyantra is also formed. You know, it's like the, you know, energy will come zoop inside and the Shriyantra will break it out. You know, the things will start flowing from here, there, then it will like distract the entire energy from the that thing. And only the pure form of energy will go down. Only the pure form of energy, that is why this is empty. That is why the core is empty. Core is going to have the purest form of energy. So now this is the three-dimensional or multi-dimensional thing. But when you get into the two-dimensional, that yantra loses its power. That yantra is not going to help you anymore because his one-dimensional is lost. You know, in terms of Shriyantra, it's a multi-dimensional thing. So now that mantra, yantra is not going to help you because it got converted into two-dimensional thing now. And then another thing which you all are not aware about a yantra, because the logo is yantra as well, that yantra needs a proper element to hold its energy. So if you carve Shri Yantra in plastic, you know, a lot of people are doing this thing with the yantras. They are making yantra in plastic. So plastic chemical composition is not that strong to hold any kind of energy, you know. So the platinum, the gold, you know, gold has a lot of strong, you know, a lot of weight in terms of atomic weight. Gold has the maximum atomic weight. So because of that atomic weight, now gold is able to hold out the energy of the energy of this symbol or energy of the yantra. So if you're carving the Shri Yantra on plastic, or if you're carving the, you know, yantras on in plastic, say pyramids in plastic, those things are not going to add value to your life at all, because they are lifeless. No, their chemical composition is not strong enough to hold out the energy. So a lot of people, you must have used those plastic yantras in your office here and there, so it might have helped you, no doubt, but along the way, it will lose out its energy. Whatever, you know, mantra vidhi or tantra vidhi you have done to charge it up, it will go away after certain days. So now, if you make similar yantra in gold or silver or copper, then it will sustain the energy for longer duration. Gold being the highest, silver being, you know, in between, and copper is the minimal. If you have wood, it will lose effect very fast. So whenever you have yantra in your home, in your offices, so make sure that yantras are being carved in the right kind of metal, you know. So that thing is going to help you out as well. Great. So a lot of people watch the video today. Ruma is still watching, and I don't know. Okay, so